I'm Guillermo Scaglia at the LSU Ag Center at Dean Lee. We're going to be talking today about weaning and alternatives to reduce stress during that that period of time. As you know, weaning can be very stressful to the cow, but especially to the calf. There are a lot of new things that are coming out after weaning. It can be the environment. The calf may be placed in pens or may be placed in a different pasture than what he used to be. There might be some other type of stressors, like for example the environment. There might be too much mud in pens. It can be other different situations that the calf had to confront. And most importantly, we also have to consider that usually there is also nutritional factors. The animal is not going to be with his mama anymore, so he's not going to be drinking milk. And it will probably have a new feed stuff also available for him. So all those can be stressors for the calf. The way we need to think about is that we need to try to reduce the stress of this animal at this period. So there are two strategies that we can use in order to reduce stress at weaning. One of them is the use of nose clips, or what is called the two-stage weaning. We have a calf that we just put a nose clip on him, and he's now with his mama back here in one of the pens. There are some other type of nose clips that you can use, and these are not the only ones that you can find. There are many others, and they are all basically doing the same work. What it is basically you place these nose clips on the calf, and you prevent the animal from nursing. So he cannot be drinking milk anymore while he has these nose clips. One of the things is basically what you're doing is trying to break the bond between the dam and the calf. And that's what these nose clips are helping you to do. These will, sooner or later, in a few days, it will make that the calf will wander by himself, or the cow will not be paying too much attention to him anymore. At the moment of weaning is the time that you take the nose clip out of the calf. By the way, they can be reusable in next year. You just need to wash them and store them in a dry place. And you can keep using this year after year. The calf, after the normal weaning, once you separate the calf from the cow, it will be a lot more calmer than if you do what we call abrupt weaning, or weaning directly from the dam out of her side. The other way of reducing stress is what we use also is called fence line weaning. And that's what it is. It's basically you put the calf separated from the cow in adjacent pastures. They are just separated by a fence. Now this fence has to be a good fence. It has to be in good shape and hot, of course, so that you make sure that the calf and the cow they don't get back together. The idea is basically that the cow and the calf can see each other and they can hear each other, but basically you are breaking the bond that they cannot be touching each other. So this type of activities can help reduce the stress of the calf. We did a few experiments in the past dealing with this type of weaning alternatives, and we show that, for example, animals that were with the nose clips spend less time grazing. And if you wonder why, it's basically because they were after the mama trying to nurse. And that time that they spend with them or trying to nurse, of course they didn't do it, they didn't do the grazing as the other treatments did, the fence line and the animals that remain with the cow. Also, they spend a lot of time very close to the dam because of what I just said. They were trying to nurse and they were giving a lot more tries trying to reach to the milk. And finally, of course, because of that activity and because of that lack of grazing, the gains that they did while they were using the nose clips were lower than those animals that were fence-lined or normal weaned. In the case of the fence line, things were much better. They were not as worried about what the mama was doing. They spent some time close to the fence the first day, but they didn't feel stressed at all. The gains that they did before weaning was a little lower than the conventional weaned or abruptly weaned calves, and much better than the nose clips. Now, once we got to weaning, we separated the groups, and they weighed different pastures. Animals that used the nose clips before weaning, they gained more weight than those that were fence lined, and the ones that were abruptly weaned, the control treatment, they gained very little after weaning. I'm talking about 7 days. Period before weaning and 7 days period after weaning. So the gains and the behavior of those calves were during that period of time. The other thing that we noticed is that animals spend a lot more time, animals that were conventional and weaned spent more time vocalizing and just trying to call for their dam. They had around 45 to 50 vocalizations per minute in the first day, and as they passed, those vocalizations or the number of vocalizations per day were reduced. We also put this piece of equipment is a pedometer on the leg of the calves. It's basically to measure the number of steps they took, and what we notice is that, of course, those animals that were conventionally weaned walk a lot more than those that were fence lined or with the nose clips before weaning. That makes sense from the standpoint they were basically searching for their mama, vocalizing and taking a lot more steps. In terms of the average daily gain for the two periods, the 7 days before weaning and the 7 days after weaning, on average the fence line calves gained more. It was around 3/4 of a pound than the conventionally weaned. It was around 0.5, and the nose clips was also around 0.4, 0.5 pounds per day. All right. One of the things that that you need to consider whenever you're using the nose clips, they have to be placed on the calves for at least a week in order to do the trick. It may sound like a lot of work to bring the herd and run them through the chute just to put this on the calves. Maybe you can take the opportunity to also deworm the cattle or vaccinate or whatever else you need to do. In the case of the fence line weaning, the main thing is that the fence has to be in good shape. We use net wire with two offsets, one in each side, one for the cows, one for the calves. It has worked really well. Of course, you cannot hold cows separated from calves just with one string of wire. I really think that these two alternatives can help you with reducing stress of calves at weaning. And of course, I hope this information was very useful for you. Thank you very much.